One thing about the presence of the Lord gives you, in the presence of God, that's where the creation takes place. In the presence of the Lord, that's where ideas come, breakthrough ideas. It's in the presence of the Lord that I get all the ideas. Years ago, when I started preaching, when I was 14, I saw that everybody I preached to, Pastor Dan and Pastor Daniel, that's good, your beautiful wife, I have double blessing. I've got Apostle Daniel there, and I have the Apostle Dan here and his wife. It's just a double. And we are in the year of 5, 7, 7, 8. That's double. Beginning.
Hallelujah.
Grace, 5. Perfection. New beginning, 8. And that's where we are. So God is going to perfect everything. We are going to enter into Jubilee time. So, I've seen the day rise. One of my first time to see somebody rise from being raised from the dead, it was over the phone around 2 a.m. when somebody said, Pastor, somebody's dead. Then I was half asleep. My mind was not working well. So I just said, I speak life in that body. And the person came back to life. And what happened is the ambulance came and went back empty.
Yes.
They said, where is the dead person? He says, oh, this is the one that died, but something happened. He called some kind of the pastor, and some kind of power went in him, and he jumped up like an electric shock, and he's alive now. They were pretty upset because they just spent the gas, and then they drove back. That's just like my first. Then I come to California. One of the girls dying, her name was Amanda. She was half dead. And one of the friend of mine takes me there to say, can you pray for Amanda? I said, I'm on vacation. I don't want to pray for anybody. I do that in Africa every day, night and day. Yeah. I am here in vacation. He says, please, can you come and pray for Amanda? I didn't know what was the type of the Amanda situation. Amanda, when I went there, she was almost dead. Jesus. And I said, Lord, I've been in a vacation mode. I'm in a miracle ministry mode. I don't have faith for this, but I started singing.
Hallelujah.
As I started worshiping God, as I sang and worshiped God. The power of God came upon Amanda, and Amanda was resurrected from the dead. It's not in Africa. That first one was in Africa. The second one I'm talking about was in California, in Santa Maria area. So Amanda asked me, can you come to my church, please? I said, but I didn't come here for churches. I came on vacation. I just finished hosting a friend of mine, Michael W. Smith, on the crusade we had, a crusade concert plus, soul winning. So, you know, when you have a stadium meeting, you need some little bit of vacation. Because there's a lot of work that takes place. So, God can change your vacation into something powerful. So I walk in the church. I'm a guest. I said, don't introduce me that I'm a minister. Just introduce me as a tourist. To try and avoid any kind of invitation to start preaching again. So I walk in the church. I found people there. Just dancing. As I'm walking, everybody was falling off under the power of God. Everybody. Then I said, who is this African guy? Skinny African man just walking and everybody's falling from the left and right. I'm saying, Holy Ghost, what's going on here? I need to hide.
I'm on vacation.
My Lord Wiggles said, I'm not on vacation. That day, almost everybody was on the ground. I didn't even preach. People were slain. They didn't even know who I was. People were slain. And imagine a stranger walks here and everybody gets slain. Then people started showing up. One man shows up and said, I am your armor bearer. The other one said, I'm going to call the pastors. We need this revival. I've been seeing this. Before you know, there was 40 churches wanting me to speak. 40 churches, a stranger from Africa. Everything. Then I preached in a Jack Efford vice president's church. I didn't even know that Jack Efford was a big deal here. But the vice president of Jack Efford invited me to speak in his church. And he says, we don't normally bring nine foursquare. But for you, when I saw you, I felt the power of God. I feel you need to speak in this church. Then I said, I got to go to Hawaii first. Then I'll come back. So I went to Hawaii. I got some suffering there where David and Joanna, they're suffering right now in Hawaii. So I went to suffer there too. Then I spoke for youth of the mission for Lowell and Cunningham for a week. The whole school, there was about 70 to 80 students. They all went wild. I told them about the healing stories by demonstrating. There was somebody who was, I don't know if it's crippled or what. I said, come, let's practice on this one that God heals. God healed that person. Then I said, all of you students, now go and do the same. Go and heal everyone. So they went on the campus asking for miracle. Who needs a miracle and healing? Then I meet Matthew Crouch of TBN. He says, can you be on the Praise the Lord? Then I said, I'm not dressed enough, maybe tomorrow. He says, man, can you be on Praise the Lord? I said, no, I'm not dressed now for new tomorrow. He says, whatever you say. Then I said, who sent you? He said, Roland Canyons. Oh, those people are big. I cannot tie them down. I cannot tend them down. Then I said, but tomorrow I'll be ready. Then in the morning, I found Matthew and Mark Anderson. We did Praise the Lord on TBN. We had a great time. Things started happening. Then I flew back, preached in Foursquare Church. Over 100 people got healed without even laying hands on anybody. It had the first service and the second service. The people of the first service, they didn't want to leave. Ashes tried to drag them out. They said, no, I'm not going. You can take my seat, but I'm going to stand here. So we had a double service, but I'm glad God's wisdom was so good that when I knew it was time up, I stopped and I went to the green room on the back so that it's not my problem, it is the pastor's problem. So the pastor was talking about, people need to go, you know, this is second service, he says, no, we're going to stay. So we had a double service. The new people that came, they just fell under the power of God. They didn't even know what they were. They didn't even know what they are facing. They didn't hear my message or anything. They just got touched by God's power. And the pastor told me that there were some people who were not happy that you are coming because they don't know you very well. But those are the first people that were on the floor. How did you do that? I said, I didn't do it, but the Holy Ghost did it. Those are the same people who say, I can feel the fire of God. And the pastor in the green room said, God really loves you, walks with you, right? Those are the same people who are giving me trouble by giving you the platform. Then I went to another church. They told me, please don't push anybody. We told you, push people and people for us. If you've been in my services, God's services, I never push people. The Holy Ghost just does it. Is it not so? You wonderful lady, come.
Yes. The Holy Ghost wants to touch you. That's what he told me. Because he wants to use you. Just stand right there.